This court and the law give to you the right to make the last statement to the court before judgment is pronounced. Do you have anything else you'd like to say? Your Honor, Ian said, struggling to hold back tears as he spoke with hesitation. I can't take away the pain that the Newsome suffer, nor do I blame them for what they feel. They have every right. He paused, sniffling. Nor can I expect myself to not share some of the pain that they suffer. But my only desire is, his voice broke, to see justice done. He dabbed at his tears. Take your time, the judge said. That's all, Your Honor. With that, Washington sentenced Ian to 6 years, suspended on grounds that he serve a 4-month active sentence, remain on probation 5 years, and pay a $3,000 fine. Medford asked for a 5-day delay in having Ian report to jail, and it was granted. Ian's family was surprised that he got an active sentence, although his attorneys were not unhappy with it. Members of the Newsome family, however, thought the sentence too lenient. He was kind of pitiful, Francis Miller said much later of Ian. He was a nerd to be that gullible. People have to be responsible for their own actions, though I just didn't feel it was enough punishment. Before the year was out, noted Nancy Dunn, Francis's daughter, Ian would be free to start his life anew. We'd like to start new lives too, but we can't, she said. Why should he? 47. At the close of Ian's trial, reporters swarmed around the district attorney, asking why the third tape hadn't been played. On that tape, Ian asked Fritz whether he'd murdered the Newsomes, and Fritz claimed he was being set up. Fritz hinted at suicide and told Ian that he had things to do and wouldn't see him again. But only the police and attorneys knew what was on that tape, and none had made any of the contents public.